Alright, let's head back home. Don't hit me. Alright, here we go. Oh, wait. Missed it. There we go. Oh, nope, that's driveway. Little map, this map always tends to trick me sometimes. Now I think I got it. On. What the hell? Why are you honking at me? Damn it, Lamar.
Franklin, what's up?
Hey, man. I'm in a bit of a bad situation. My boy Lamar got set up. I think he up near Polito Bay at some sawmill with some baller. Could you, like, do some computer magic and look into it? Is that possible at all?
Should be. I've got a back door into the Polito Bay police network left over from the score we did up there. Give me a second here. Hold on. Yes.
So what it say?
This must be it. There are older reports of a weed operation being run by an African-American gang. The files got buried, so I'm guessing they paid off the cops.
They growing weed up there?
Growing it in the hills, most likely, but they might be packing and shipping it out of this sawmill. I'd expect a fair few of them up there.
Shit. And I'm gonna need some help. Can you tell Mike and Trevor to meet me up there?
They still aren't getting along that well.
Tell him it's for me, and it's serious. Thanks, man.
Take a little shortcut. Probably kill myself. Oh, that would have killed me, probably. Alright, come on, people. Figure out what you're doing. Oh. Come on. Okay. Back on the road. Ugh. Who? Oh, where'd you come from? See if I could catch up with him. Ugh. Thought I could take a shortcut. Come on. All right. I have a feeling me messing around like this is gonna end up getting me killed. Cause I lost a good amount of a life. How much longer do I have? Alright. It's not too bad.
Yeah. Why'd you invite this stoolie, huh? We want Lamar to be rescued, not sold to the feds.
Give it a rest, asswipe.
Man, what y'all two shut the fuck up? Now let's take a look at this place, man. Let's consider it some type of big weed store spot.
This is crawling flawless, you know? Now me and you, we don't mind you all gang warfare, but the suede box over there. Go, Trevor, I said, fight.
Then I say, shut up. Now I see the weed, where the fuck is Lamar? Oh shit, there you go.
Tell Trevor I'm gonna be up on this hill with my rifle. I don't wanna be anywhere around him when he fucks this whole thing up.
Classic, huh? He's already planning his escape.
Oh.
He runs away from the fight, I run towards it.
I saw a few possible entry points when I got here. One.
Come on. Where? Okay, here we go. So one point is here, and then the other point. Yeah, we'll go here.
Chamberlain gangster families for life, motherfuckers.
Ma, where is he?
You got a friend of ours.
Nope. You're going down.
Frank, you found Lamar yet?
No, no, just more balls.
Where you got it?
Whoa. Keep moving up, keep moving up.
Lamar, where's he at? Give us the mouthy one and we'll be gone.
Come on.
Bring out Lamar. We'll go away. Nothing I missed at. You got him?
Still no LD. I'll name drop this ass.
Oh. Alright, where are they? God damn it. Oh! Some more of you guys. Alright. Come on, don't get stuck. Alright, that should work, right? Yeah. Where'd he go? Get in, you asshole.
Way out here.
Man, I ain't finna let a little drive stand in the way of a money-making opportunity.
or get killed opportunity.
Man, you always a pessimist.
Nah, nigga, a realist. Because in reality, all them fools want to clap your ass.
Man, what a trust that, dog. I peeped out that wood chopping place when we was up this way on that Devin Weston car lift, which I still ain't been paid for, incidentally. All secluded and shit, stretching me up. I'm like, yeah, that's the perfect place to buy kush by the missing.
Perfect place to clap some fool you beefing with.
Man, I ain't even know at the time. I just thought we was going parlay.
Parlay? Nigga, please. Every time you leave the house, fools try to clap. Every meet you set up, homies there for the express purpose of clapping your ass.
Man, you sure? Because I'm sure there's been a few times.
No, I'm completely 100% sure. Every time, nigga. Whether you buying drugs, selling drugs, or discussing drugs, talking about the weather, whatever.
Man, these streets is hard, dawg. It's the hood you talking about. Maybe you forgot, since you've been bettering yourself, sitting in that house on the hill, looking down on the animals of South Central and shit.
Man, you know it ain't like that.
Do I, my nigga? Because that's the way it looked to me. I'm making the best out of what I'm giving. You know what I'm talking about? I ain't in some type of mentorship program. The only mentor I got...
And we gonna do something about that, dawg. Trust me.
Man, I ain't got people teaching me that white-collar crime shit. Ain't shit changed for me, and you ain't helping.
Ain't helping? What the fuck you call this? Me, Michael, Trevor, we all came up here to help.
The unholy fucking trinity. Ballers beware when these fools rolling together.
Jealous of Michael and Trevor?
What happened to me and you fucking shit up? Form gangsters, nigga.
So I shouldn't have called them, right? Man, I was doing everything in my power to make sure you were.
Homie, you tripping.
Make sure you wasn't clapped.
I can make sure I ain't clapped.
Clearly you can't.
Next time, homie, don't come. Motherfucker, don't come. And matter of fact, if you do come, don't bring them, dude.
Man, look, let's not talk next time. Next time, don't get your ass in the situation, all right?
It's the hood, Frank. That's what happens in the hood.
No, the fuck it don't. Not for everyone.
I'm one of them dudes that it happens
to. Oh.
Damn. I'm one of them dudes that it happens to.
Man, you gonna tell me what was going on back there?
Hood shit, homie. That's the shit that's different from the country club shit your overpaid ass is presently accustomed to.
Man, stress put us on this shit, man. Man, we gonna get on his ass.
Man, fuck that, homie. Look like I give a shit.
Nigga, I give a shit.
Stress do what he do. Niggas want me dead, be dead themselves. I ain't gonna overreact to shit.
Overreact? Man, that nigga Stress tried to get you killed, nigga.
Nigga, that's the hood. I'm still here, ain't I?
Just.
You sure Stress knew they was gonna book me?
Yeah, nigga, Stress knew. Everybody knew Stress knew. Tanisha knew Stress knew, and she don't even come around the fucking hood no more.
Damn, that nigga Stress janky like that?
Man, you don't see this? Man, Stress been screwing us from the start.
Like from back in the day?
From like the other day, dawg. Since after we went to the recycling place and D and them ballers tried to take us down.
But Stretch put in the work on D.
Yeah, man, that's survival. Remember how angry his ass got? Especially with you bringing him into this shit?
Aye, but tell me this, though. If Stretch was fucking with your boy LD, why he set us up with the deal for the brick in the first place? He'd go off and make peace with the ballers, come back, and then put us on the lick on Grove Street.
Man, you remember Grove Street? That brick was drywall. Ripping us off was probably Stretch's ideal anyway.
Damn, you think so?
It makes sense, don't it?
Man, I ain't knowing, man, maybe.
Man, Stress got in with the ballers when he was inside. Played us as marks, dawg, but a bunch of them got booked. So now they gotta come back at us. So Stress sees you out there where they doing the kush deal.
Then you show up and save the day.
Yeah, thankfully.
Man, it wouldn't even be the same if your boy LD wasn't out here getting in the shit. And FC wasn't getting him out of it. You know what I'm talking about?
Man, I don't know.
That shit was fun, nigga. Don't tell me you didn't enjoy scrapping like we did back in the day.
It ain't back in the day no more, dawg.
But it felt like it was.
Okay, fool. It was fun saving your useless ass one more fucking time.
There you go. That wasn't too hard.
You should have seen your face when I came in. You was like, shit. Like, shit, man.
Oh, bullshit, nigga.
You better check them drawers, homie. You probably shit it yourself.
Fuck you, man. I don't care if I die. It's a compliment if they sending an army after a nigga. They only send like two of the little homies to get you.
Nigga, you didn't look like they was paying you no compliment, nigga.
Must have just caught a glimpse of your ugly ass.
Nigga, you'd think
time some angel come to take your ass somewhere you never going to.
You pray to your white man God, homie. I'm going to the great plain beyond where the buffalo keep on roaming and the little squaw bitches want me to nut on their face all day.
Bitch, please.
Homie, you tripping.
I hope we get there soon. So I'm tired of listening to his ass. Could I just push him out of the car right now? I almost just want to jump out of the car and let whatever happens to him happen. But we're almost here. That takes care of that. Let's see what we got next.